Hi, Phil DeBella from FlashCast by PDB. Some of the upcoming FlashCasts that I want to record, and I'd love to hear some of your questions and personal views around, is personal brand versus company brand. I urge you to send in, use social media, Facebook. So FlashCast by PDB on Facebook is fantastic. Send in those questions because one of the up and coming FlashCast recordings will be about personal brand versus company brand. Hi, Philip DeBella, FlashCast by PDB. Today's question and topics come in from Tiana Wormsley. She's the principal at Freedom Property. Tiana, thank you so much for taking the time to send me in some of your questions and also thoughts. So let me read a little bit out. I get that your target audience would be people at established businesses, so strategic planning is useful and the idea is great for the future. But right now, I'm trying to figure out how the hell I'm going to break even next month. Tiana, I hear you. I started my company with $5,000 and I know exactly what you're talking about. However, what I do also know is that whilst your business gets further on, the strategic planning might get more elaborate. It'll get more precise. It'll get more detailed. However, the basis is that if you don't have a plan, then you're not going to succeed. So you need to have a plan from day one. You need to sit down and it can be as loose as you like, but you need to have a very clear vision of where you want to be in 12 months and 3 years. And then you also need to understand what you're passionate about. And when you're struggling to break even, and for me, I was struggling to sell coffee for 12 months. No one wanted to buy my coffee. It was the passion, the resilience. And that's why I talk about it now, that passion is resilience. You have to keep going and you have to make sure that you keep spinning the Rubik's Cube. So a tip there is take the no's. Every time somebody says no to you, take that and analyze that data. You need to understand why they say no. You need to analyze why they say no. And then you need to pivot and adjust it in terms of strategy until you start getting people to say yes. Right. It's bound to happen. It has to happen. If it doesn't happen, it means you don't have a business idea that solves problems. So if you're solving a problem, it simply is getting in front of the right people until you have matched the person to the problem that you can solve, and that will equate in business. And of course, as I said, as you go on, the strategic planning will get more elaborate. But just because you've started your business doesn't mean that you don't have a strategy. You need to have a strategy. For me at DeBella, it was to create the ultimate coffee experience. It was to manufacture fresh roasted coffee and deliver it into store and help cafe owners with their training. It was very simple. It was very basic. And then it went on to be a lot more elaborate in terms of marketing and HR support and legal support and all the rest of it. But I still had a plan, and that plan was the ultimate coffee experience. DeBella was all about the ultimate coffee experience. The next part that you go on and talk about is obviously you've decided to leave the comfort of working for somebody and go out on your own, and business is so isolating. I'm hearing you. The hardest part of business is that nobody sees it through your lens. Right? People are not going to sit there and see what you see. But the art to it is to be able to show the people around you what you're actually seeing. So at the time of DeBella, I knew what DeBella Coffee was going to stand for. It was going to be a service company. It wasn't going to be a product business. It was going to be a service business. But it was how I would take that, extrapolate that out of my head and be able to communicate it. So I would sit down and write scripts over and over again that would enable me to emotionally engage with people. Because what I say to people, it doesn't matter what's going on in your head and what you think. It doesn't matter what your lens are seeing. It's how well you can get somebody else to see what you're seeing. And in terms of the isolation, this is where you need a strong support around you. And for me, it was my wife. She was a very, very strong support. My parents were a strong support. So I was able to lean on the people that could give me that emotional support. So sometimes it'll be family, sometimes it'll be friends. You know, sometimes it needs to go and be a mentor. I was lucky enough to have family around me that I didn't need an external mentor. But some people do. They need a mentor, a mindset coach. It doesn't matter what you need, but when you're feeling isolated, you need to surround yourself with the right people that can help you on your journey. Because, you know, it's Jim Collins talks about you're the sum of the five people that you have around you. So you really do need to put, whether it's three or five people around you that are strong. And not all of them are going to be close friends or family. So they can be mentors and mindset coaches and all the rest of it. And this leads on to the next part where you talk about bouncing ideas. You need to be able to bounce ideas off everybody. However, you've got to try and keep the ego and emotion away from it. The part that makes us physically sick or makes us upset or angry or cranky is that we get too involved in the ego and emotion of what's happening. And this is something that I learned. And I mean, don't get me wrong, being a son of Sicilians, we're known for being egotistical and especially emotional. So it was a difficult thing to do. But again, having good people around me that would always say, Phil, stop, pause, reflect, which is some of the best tools that I've now built. Stop, pause, reflect, and then go is something that helps me keep that ego and emotion in check, because obviously that is what makes us, you know, have that physical reaction to what's going on. You know, in terms of planning, we all have plans. We all need to have 3 and 5 year plans. The most important plans, obviously, are what we're doing right now and in the next 12 months. And don't be afraid to pivot. I see so many people that say, no, this is my 3 year plan. But hang on, the world changes pretty quick in 3 years. So whilst you've got to have a 3 year plan, don't be afraid to pivot. You've got to, I always say, you look in the revision mirror to use that knowledge to know where you're going right now. So you look in the past to build the future based on where you are right now. Now is where it's happening, but you need to take the past and blend it to the future and act now. Because if you live in the past, you're going to go backwards. If you live too much in the future, you're never going to get anything done. So it's having that perfect harmony between it all. But the power of now, Eckhart Tolle wrote a good book about it. It's all about what's happening right now. Of course, when you start in any business, it's all about sales. So it's all about making sales happen. You know, it's all good to get caught up in the marketing and the branding and the storytelling and the long strategic planning, but you need to truncate it back to what's important right now. So a very simple tip, you know, and probably a very key takeaway for you, Tiana, is are you doing the best that you can at the time that it's happening with the resources that you have? So the biggest tip out of today's Flashcast for everyone, and especially for you, Tiana, is to sit down with a piece of paper and say, am I doing the best that I can with the resources that I have at the time that it's happening? Now, this will tick the physical side. This will tick the ego and emotional side, but it'll also help you start to develop a plan. And it really is about self-care. It's about mindset, and it's also about getting pen and paper down. You'll hear me talk about it all the time. Our brains have over 16,000 conversations a day with ourselves, so it's important that we get ideas onto pen and paper so we don't drive ourselves mad. Sit down and really analyze, am I doing the best that I can at the time that it's happening with the resources that I have? And if you can answer yes, yes, and yes, well then get on with the show. If you answer no, write down the why, and then go about building strategy to what's going on around that, right? So I hope that helps. Tiana, I thank you for your question. I urge all other listeners to send in their questions and topics, and don't be afraid to throw in some commentary like Tiana has. It's all about you. You're listening to Philip DiBella on Flashcast by PDB. Please subscribe, share with your friends, and rate the Flashcast.